Check out these three. What do you think of the one on the left?
Great. But I like them thinner.
Well, how about the one on the right?
Ooh, that looks too thin.
But how about the luscious one in the middle?
Perfect. And we can share.
Only Pizza Hut offers deep pan, thin and crispy, and delicious hand-tossed.
Hi, I'm the luscious one in the middle. All right, maybe I'm not.
Pizza Hut, making it great.
You may like the way you look when you smoke, but have you ever stopped to think how you look to others?
Yellow tooth.
Just stinks.
Disgusting.
Smells like a butt. It looks just slimy and gross. I just can't stand to be near it.
And welcome back to the St. Paul Civic Center, the number one rated team in the state against the number one Metro team. You'd expect it to be this way. 1-1 after two periods, Kennedy and Grand Rapids. Now let's go down to Tony Parker. Some more information and some special guests. Tony?
Well, first of all, gentlemen, here we are with the third school to be drawn as one of the eight finalists in the Toyota School Spirit Contest. And it is Atwater Grove City. Congratulations to the Blazers and good luck. Of course, we will announce five more and then the winner will be announced Saturday night in our special pregame show. Also Saturday night, of course, we'll award the WCCO TV trophy for the best cheerleading team. And we're going to introduce you now from Greater Minnesota, the Grand Rapids cheerleaders. Let's get their names and year in school. We'll start with you.
Tisha Houston, I'm a sophomore.
Jenny Flink, and I'm a junior.
Margaret Karkala, sophomore.
Shelby Lane, I'm a junior.
Marcy Garfield, I'm a junior.
Melanie Brown, I'm a junior.
Okay, notice they are not all seniors. We got a young crew. Let's ask the coach about it. Coach, come on in here. This is Jamie Loma, I have it right?
Yeah, that's right.
All right, first off, Jamie is not only the coach of the cheerleaders, but has a brother right there in the tournament this year. He is?
Jeff Wilson, number 17.
Jeff, number 17. I was sitting with Jamie for a couple of minutes waiting for this break, guys, and when Grand Rapids got the goal, she about knocked me out of the stands. Obviously, you've had some experience in cheerleading, but let me ask you, what's the routine for the team? How much practice? What kind of routines?
Well, we practice about once a week, once or twice a week, it depends. Like on every Sunday night, we have a practice on the ice. Then on Mondays after school, we practice from about 3:30 till 5:30, and we go, that's on the land, and we do all our jumps and our mounts. And we work on voice projection, we work on, you know.
Is it tough to make the team?
Yeah, I think so. You have, you know, it depends. Everybody's.
Is it tough to make the team?
Yeah.
Well, you heard it. Grand Rapids is here and eligible for that trophy. We'll see on Saturday night. Now back to you guys.
All right, Tony, thank you much. They have as many players coming back in the cheerleading squad as Grand Rapids has in the hockey team. A lot of juniors on that squad. Well, we had a scoreless game going into that second period, and Kennedy broke that scoreless tie. Captain Greg Hansen, number 12. 6-3, a real rugged defenseman with a hard shot going through the pads of the goaltender right there. Houston just trickling across the red line. 1-0 Kennedy.
And what a great play it was by Chris Marinucci here right there, number 9. And turning around, getting the shot away, only the fifth power play goal against Kennedy this year. That's the goal for Grand Rapids that tied it at 1-1. And
Ben Scheibe has been rated the number one Metro goalie, second in the state. Not often tested in some of these games, but he has really showed a lot of poise. And as Lou Nanny remarked, that's a real classy move right there. Under pressure, coming through with that, covering up the rebound. And as we check the goalie saves after two periods, much more active one for Scheibe. Also in the quality of saves in that second period. Now he has a total of 16, and Houston for Grand Rapids sitting at 22. And the score is sitting at 1-1. Live from the St. Paul Civic Center, this is continuing coverage of the 1990 Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
Particularly picky people do everything for picture-perfect soybeans. You pick at lamb's quarters and pesky pigweed and get pretty punchy pulling velvet leaf. But now, you can tank mix, new Pinnacle herbicide. It's extra punch, pounds problem weeds to a pulp. New DuPont Pinnacle, the post picky people pick.
Over here, 126,000 miles, yeah.
Faces, you're addicted to love.
16 Toyotas.
right, Kate?
Addicted to love. Might as well face it, you're addicted to love.
There are some more negative forces and factors facing kids nowadays than there were even when I was growing up. The most pervasive is drug use, because they didn't have a lot of drugs on the market. It wasn't the thing to do. It wasn't chic. It wasn't cool. It wasn't a rite of passage. And all your friends didn't do it. So you didn't gear yourself towards that. You didn't want to experiment. You didn't want to try. But now we see that just even experimentation, it's going to hurt you. No matter what you gain in the short term, you're going to lose in the long term.
Find out how far your money can go at TCF. Just open or add to any qualifying account, and you're eligible for low one-way airfares on Midway Airlines. How low? Just $69 to New York, Dallas-Fort Worth, or Atlanta. Contact any TCF office or the connection for details and see how far your money can go.
Anoka won our first game today, 2-1 over South St. Paul, and a goal by Steve Magnuson late in the third period. Right now we are 1-1 Grand Rapids and Kennedy. And, of course, Grand Rapids, they're hoping to repeat their 1980 state championship victory. They were the best 10 years ago, and they hope to be the best in 1990.
Okay, we got a big video, guys. Everybody's got to pay attention. Everybody's got to get into it. Ready? Let's go.
Was great. It's a wrap.
By Grand Rapids Indians. Once again, WCCO Television is honoring the cheerleading squads who put so much time and effort into their teams. Right now, we have an explainer on that cheerleading contest for you.
They spend hundreds of hours in cold arenas, practicing, perfecting, and performing their skills. Like other athletes, hockey cheerleaders make a commitment to excellence, and we think their efforts deserve recognition. For the fourth year, WCCO Television is sponsoring the high school hockey cheerleading competition. One squad from each school participating in the tournament is judged on a scale of 1 to 5 according to the following criteria: ice performance, crowd control, cheerleading skills. Our three judges, chosen in cooperation with the Minnesota State High School League, will have the difficult task of determining which squad is our number one. Judge Corey Eichelberger, Wyzetta High School cheerleading coach.
I guess I look for a girl who looks like she's having fun. If a girl's out there and she's
She's yelling and she's jumping up and down and she's really into the game. She's supporting her team and she's trying to get the crowd involved, and that can be so much fun to watch. It's like watching a performance, and so that can be as much fun watching cheerleaders as it can be to watch the actual game itself.
I think I'd want the job of trying to find a winner there, but the top cheerleading squad will receive its trophy Saturday night during our countdown to championship show, and that's at 7 o'clock, right before the game.
All right, Ralph, and this is Hockey 90, continuing coverage of the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
Add style and beauty to your home with savings from Menards. All lock sets by Harlock are on sale. Choose one for your home. A brass passage lock set is $4.99, or this brass deadbolt for only $8.99. Save on pre-hung oak interior doors with trim, ready to install with three sturdy brass hinges. Choose from five sizes starting at just $54.88. Save on doors and more this week at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Everybody knows that milk's for babies. Charming, disarming, whatever they do. Wouldn't you know it, baby? Milk's for you. Soft baby skin, strong baby bones, bright baby smile.
Once you start, you won't be able to stop. Rollerblade. If not now, when?
It's here. $5 million worth of cars, trucks, and RVs. Auto Show 90 revs up at the new downtown Minneapolis Convention Center. Make tracks.
WCCO-TV is your choice for news in the 90s. For innovative coverage of issues that affect the community. For up-to-the-minute weather and the best local sports coverage. WCCO News. Number one at noon, 5, 6, 10, and weekends is your choice for news in the 90s.
The next step for the Grain Belt Brewery. The details at 5.
Well, Scott Reynolds has been snooping around the Kennedy and Grand Rapids locker rooms after the second period. Scott, what'd you found out?
Well, Mark, if Grand Rapids looked like a different team to you in that second period, that's what Indians coach Lynn Ellingson expected. He told me that despite their 24-1 record, they had only led after the first period in three games this year. They really did look like a different team. Coach Peterson of Kennedy told his team that they got lazy. They were just reaching for the puck, trying to knock it off the stick of the Indians rather than checking them hard. And he also said the Indians defensemen are coming up too much. He said we can get some breakaways if we bounce some passes out to center ice. So watch for that.
All right, Scott, thanks much. We've also had a couple of complaints talking about the ice surface, which has been a little bumpy, according to a couple of coaches. So we'll see how that develops as the tournament progresses. Ted, Louis.
All right. Louis, do you think we're in sudden, is it close to sudden death? Is one goal going to win this?
I think one goal is going to win it unless it's an open net goal. I think each of these clubs have played strong defensively, and I don't see one team pulling away that easily.
And it's shot into the Kennedy end as we start the third period. And it's flipped out to center ice from Marinucci. The goal scorer for Grand Rapids fires it back, and it goes up into the Kennedy bench. And out of play. A lot of the pride of the range, particularly with Grand Rapids in this tournament. And interestingly enough, Jerry Peterson behind the Kennedy bench has been one of the most vocal proponents of the two-tier tournament.
Well, there's a lot of talk about that. It's going to be interesting to see how it comes down.
Chris Rosso will play tonight in the fourth game. They'll be playing White Bear Lake. Burnsville and Minnetonka will meet in the 7 o'clock game. Fired ahead to the Kennedy end. A centering pass sticked away by Shivey, and he sticked it between the defense all the way back to the Grand Rapids end, where Tony Retka chases it down. For Brian Knobs, he can't clear it out. It's checked away by Connick. He fires it around to the far side. Retka there first, backhanding it ahead. Hansen knocked it down, but back comes Wilson with a flip on net that Shibe steers to the near side. Now Hansen, he has the Kennedy goal in the game. And Hansen overskates coming out. Marinucci takes it. Marinucci puts it back through the slot on the stick of Beltier, and his wrist shot over the sliding Hansen is gloved by Shibe.
It's a good thing he held on to it, because Marinucci was coming right out of the corner and he was right on the doorstep. It was a fine shot to get it over the sliding defender of Bloomington Kennedy that looked for a moment like there was no room for the Grand Rapids defenseman to get the shot away, but he got it right over top and Shibe had to make the save.
A minute 16 gone by in the third period of a 1-1 game. Peterson and Holum were on that draw, and it's kicked back to the blue line. Here's Beltier, and his shot steered in the far corner by Shibe. He did a very good job steering the rebounds. Now we have a whistle and a penalty coming up. A high-sticking penalty is coming up. I believe it's against Grand Rapids. It's 1-1, and this is Hockey 90 live from the St. Paul Civic Center.
Jeff Nielsen's not too happy. He's going to get a high-sticking call here. He felt the stick was being held right here, and he went to pull it free, and he gets called for high-sticking. Now Grand Rapids has to kill off a penalty. It's 1-1 tie. Third period, 13:31 to go.
Second power play chance for Kennedy, but here's a puck poked ahead, and Kuzi for Grand Rapids almost had a break. Kuzi and Adam Roy up front to kill it for the Indians. They flip it ahead. The Eagles of Kennedy have Hansen and Scott playing the points. And they start with Peterson, Russian, and Thompson up front. So a mixed line here on the power play for Kennedy. Good job by Roy deep in the Kennedy end, killing time. Boy, an excellent job here by Grand Rapids. Now with 1:25 to go in the man advantage. Here comes Kennedy. Up hops over Thompson's stick. Deep Beltier with it. Looks to the far side, racing into Scott, trying to keep it in, but it's cleared by Kuzi to center. Adam Roy pressuring, and it's finally shot by Kennedy back. A minute 5 in the man advantage. Pressured by Russian. Puck taken by Rapids. And it's cleared, but not out. Puck hops funnily into the slot, and it is cleared by Adam Roy to center. 50 seconds to the man advantage, and Kennedy has had nothing yet. Here's Marinucci backhanding it ahead. Now poking it down the right side. Marinucci has Wilson in the slot right in front, and Shibe had to stand his ground and stick it away. Now here's Connick down the right side. His blast. Oh, and that confused Houston, who got a piece of it. Now a penalty coming up against Kennedy as Retka was pulled down by John Russian. Now it's dumped ahead, and John Russian of Kennedy will be going off. And in 16 seconds, a man advantage for Grand Rapids. It's 1-1, and this is Hockey 90 live from the St. Paul Civic Center.
Find out how far your money can go at TCF. Just open or add to any qualifying account, and you're eligible for low one-way airfares on Midway Airlines. Like $69 to Boston, $109 to the Bahamas, and just $119 to Las Vegas. Contact any TCF office or the Connection for details and see how far your money can go.
A pair of 16s in the penalty box. You're going to see Russian get a hooking penalty right here for Kennedy with number 16 Nielsen already in the box. 16 seconds to go on his penalty for the Rapids, and they'll have a power play, their second of the afternoon. A good chance for Kennedy just previous to that. Houston stride to make a save. It hit the inside and just went by the net.
Off the draw, Tony Retka's blast wide. Here's Brian Knobs in, shooting, and he missed the net as well. Markstrom with it for Kennedy. Wrapped around behind the net. And now the penalty to Grand Rapids is over, and they have the net advantage for a minute and 40 seconds. And Kennedy's Hansen killing time behind the net. Over to Rob Vierling, and he clears the zone. Retka at center. And it back in, was offside, waved off. And here is Vierling to center. Ooh, on the right side, he almost had Markstrom breaking in behind the defense. Markstrom leaves the puck, and it's played by Nielsen. Now here's Rapids with 1:15 on the man advantage. Nielsen feeding, coming in, a shot goes over the net by Troy Kuzi. And then Nielsen, Jeff Nielsen, goes in and knocks the net off the Magnets. To stop play with 1:08 on the power play.
That's the prettiest end-to-end play of the afternoon. A three-way passing play coming up the ice. Finally, with a good opportunity, you see right here, shot just got deflected at the last minute. At the last second, Kuzi's shot was deflected right over the glass after a fine pass from Nielsen to put him in all alone. Grand Rapids, so moving that puck smartly, coming up the ice, right out of their zone. Three little passes and man in all alone. Just missed a good opportunity.
Here's Marinucci now playing the point. A minute to go in the man advantage. Puck got through, sneaking in front. A shot is in. Score! Grand Rapids! Scheibe made the initial save and it was poked home. A power play goal and Grand Rapids leads 2-1.
Well, all it took was just a pass coming out, an outlet pass that was missed on the boards. Kennedy couldn't get it out. Marinucci keeps it in, and he kept it in deep, as you see right there. He had put it in deep, and Jeff Nielsen's going to put it away as the puck came free to him all alone. Just previous to where we picked it up here, Kennedy had a chance to get it out. Marinucci keeps it in, and he gets it down deep to Roy. Roy across to Nielsen, and Nielsen put it away. So that'll be Nielsen from Roy and Marinucci. As Grand Rapids capitalizes again on a power play, their second power play goal of the afternoon. Kennedy had only given up a few, as we were saying earlier, all year, has been victimized twice today.
And the leading goal scorer for Grand Rapids, Jeff Nielsen, gives them the lead at 4:16 of the third period. Just four power play goals allowed by Kennedy all year, and Grand Rapids has scored two in this game. Now Kennedy trying to put some pressure on. Puck dumped in front by Paul Thompson. It's broken up. Sent to the far side. Mark Peterson takes a hit from Marinucci. And Worley wraps it around the boards. But Wilson can't get it out. Now it's Beltier for Grand Rapids. Banks ahead to Wilson. And he gets it out across the blue line. Now chipped ahead by Marinucci. Troy Kuzi chasing it down. He's spun in his own end. Now they'll try to freeze him in the corner. Marinucci works it free, can't get it in front. Mark Scott banks to the far side. Jason Berg is there for Kennedy. Clears at center where it's kicked ahead by Peterson, and he is flattened by Beltier at the Rapids line.
Beltier's had a strong game for Rapids on the defense today. And what a check he laid out there.
Here comes Kuzi down the right wing, trying to feed Marinucci behind him. And Kennedy will rush back the other way. Tipped ahead. Here's Connick down the right side. Got by the defender in front. Trying to tuck it home, and he could not. Houston held the post. Now Connick behind the net. Centers in the slot. Shot by Thompson. Hit someone. Now Connick again. Dumping it around to the near side. St. John in deep. Flips it up into the glove of Retka for Grand Rapids, and he hangs on. A break of the action, and we'll be right back with the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
This GMC Safari could be the perfect family vehicle.
It's good looking, it's safe, it's got all-wheel drive,
and you can get one at your Vikingland GMC truck dealers.
9:08 remaining in the third period. Grand Rapids leading 2-1, face-off to Houston's left in the Grand Rapids zone.
Connick wins the draw, pulls it to Trimborn, but a weak shot steered away. Now in the corner. Kana comes in to steal, puts it back to the blue line. Hansen is there. His shot is saved with the blocker pad by Houston, and he stares it up in the crowd.
I think that you're going to see Jerry Peterson, the coach of Kennedy, shorten his bench with only 8:55 to go. Expect to see Connick, Markstrom, and Trimborn out there quite a bit. Each of these teams only go in three lines as it is, but I think you'll see Connick's line almost getting double shifted. They'll take extra long shifts and be coming back more often than usual as long as they trail in this game.
Connick's done a good job on draws in this game. Tried to win another one there. Now Markstrom couldn't get by Worley. And it's steered out over the line to center by Jeff Nielsen. St. John with it for Kennedy. Fires it around the boards. Markstrom in deep. Chips behind the cage. Beltier up the near side. Adam Roy can't get it out. Kept in. Trimborn sends it around. Here's Connick. Back at the blue line. Hansen a blast. It's blocked. And here comes Rapids out. It's Jeff Nielsen in. Nielsen. He is spun around and brought down. And that'll be a penalty. Kirby St. John of Kennedy. And so Rapids leading 2-1. We'll have another power play. We'll be right back with the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
Find out how far your money can go at TCF Bank and earn low one-way airfares on Midway Airlines. Contact TCF for details.
No doubt about this hooking penalty to Kirby St. John. He gets his stick caught under the arm of Jeff Nielsen, pulls him down right here, and Grand Rapids already successful 2 out of 2 times on the power play this afternoon, leading 2-1, go on their third power play of the day with 8:16 to go in the third period and the chance to widen their lead.
Here's Marinucci at the point. A defender went down, and we're going to get a penalty to even it right up off the faceoff. Kennedy defender was pulled down off the draw, and Grand Rapids, after 3 seconds, is penalized and put it back to even strength.
Well, it was a holding penalty right there after the draw. The puck comes back to the blue line. You'll see the puck coming back to the blue line right here, and the defenseman's going to walk in and take a shot. There's no doubt about it. He just grab him to spin him around, and as he does that, he just draws a penalty 3 seconds after they went to power play. So Roy goes off for holding. Yeah,
great break for Kennedy.
It's a big break. You don't want to take penalties in the offensive zone, especially at this stage of the game. When you're leading, you got the chance to extend that lead. And you know the referees are going to be watching close at a time like that, right after the other team's been given the penalty.
Now we play 4 skaters aside. Virtually 2 minutes. It'll be 3 seconds when Kennedy will have an advantage. But back in the Rapids end, Marinucci dumps it ahead. His man wasn't looking. It's stolen by Vierling, coming with a shot. Score! Tipped in front. And we are tied at 2.
Thompson is just on his knees in front of the net, got knocked down, and that shot's coming. He's got the blade of his stick on the ice. And the shot comes from the side. An outlet clearing pass didn't get out. It's kept in by Kennedy. Watch Thompson. As that shot comes from Vierling, he's on the ice. See him get knocked down in front of the net right here? He's getting knocked down. The shot's coming. It's going to hit the blade of his stick right there. Goes in the net to beat Houston and tie the game. Big goal for Kennedy, trailing 2-1. And right after, it looks like they were going to be on the shorthanded situation. They get a power play nullified with a penalty, and then they go ahead and score to tie it at 2.
Wonderful tip by the junior, Paul Thompson. And so 7:51 remaining, and we are now in a new game again, tied at 2.
He had the presence of mind, Ted, to look at that puck and get his blade on it while he's going down. Real good play by him.
Still at 4 skaters aside. Here's Thompson coming back with Peterson on the right. Pass too far. Peterson sends it on net. Now behind the net, Knobs took a hit. And Rapids back to play it. Here comes Nielsen. He is knocked down. He went over the stick of Peterson. Back here's Knobs at the blue line. He puts it on and it goes wide. Retka will play it near side. He flips it. Scheibe lets it go through. Knobs coming in deep behind the net. Scott will play it. Scott off the boards to Peterson. Backhanding it ahead.
Each of these clubs now have been victimized with an outlet pass that they didn't get out, and the defenseman stepped in and created an opportunity, and the goal was scored.
Marinucci leaving the ice now for Rapids after flipping that in. Connick and Trimborn up front for Kennedy. 5 seconds left on the man short situations. That's sent back in by Tom Worley and pinned in the corner to Ben Scheibe's right. 6:42 remaining in a 2-2 game.
So Peterson has shortened his bench already. Even with a tie game, he came right back with Connick line again. Connick had just gone off when the penalty came about to Bloomington Kennedy. Thompson was out there killing it. As soon as their shift was up, Connick comes right back out again.
St. John's penalty for Kennedy over in 26 seconds. Roy's for Rapids in 29. Still playing four aside. Here's a shot from Worley, and that missed the net. And it will carry him hard to the far side, and Beltier got there quickly to keep it in. Now in front of the net in the slot, it's poked ahead by Cochran to center. Here comes Hansen. Hansen has Connick streaking in front. There it is, and Connick just missed it. Good chance for Kennedy. Now in the slot, it's Hansen again with a shot that goes wide. Sent back to the near boards. Connick following it in. Both teams now back to full strength. Five skaters apiece with 6:05 remaining, kept in by Hansen. His shot and deflected by Houston, up and over the glass and out of play. There's a break in the action, and we'll be right back with the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
You have to take more than two or three people more than 2 or 3 miles.
The best way to do it is with a full-size conversion van from GMC Truck.
Well, Hansen does it again. The outlet pass from Grand Rapids being picked off. He had two opportunities there to get goal. Both shots deflected before they got to the net.
Now here comes Rapids in on a break. Flipped ahead and a shot hit the post. A shot by Wilson hit the post as he flipped it up high over the fallen Scheibe. And it's cleared to center. Mike Earhart with a wonderful pass to set that play up. Now Wilson will get another try in front. He pokes it just wide. Behind the net, Nielsen trying to center. And it's broken up, still loose behind the Kennedy cage. Here's Wilson back at the blue line, and it's broken up. And back comes Kennedy. This is Kevin David down the right wing. He flips it wide. And to the far side, it's poked to center with 5:15 to play in regulation. Tied at 2. Players sprawling. Up loose, and Retka plays it for the Indians. Brian Dobbs passing in front of his own net. Retka just fires it ahead to Jeff Wilson. Wilson down the right side, streaking in, and a blast from a bad angle hit the side of the net as Troy Cousy let it fly, and it caroms up over the glass with 4:52 to play.
Well, you see Grand Rapids had a 3-on-1, an opportunity to score, didn't do it. Then from behind the net, Nielsen was trying to flick that puck over top of the net to get it out in the slot to Earhart. He didn't quite get it done, though. But Grand Rapids having the opportunity to pull ahead, beaten by the pipe.
A little shuffle here by Lynn Ellingson. He has Marinucci now out between Cousy and Adam Roy. So a little line shifting here. 4:40 to play in regulation, tied at 2. Deep in the Grand Rapids end now. Jason Berg is bumped off the play. Worley flips it up the boards. Adam Roy can't clear it out. Sent on net wide from the blue line by Mark Peterson. Out of the far side, it's flipped by Cousy high to center ice. Beltier pins Berg into the boards. Shot ahead off Marinucci's stick. Puck flipping back in the Kennedy end. Beerling could not get control of it, and Rapids keeps it in. Here's Cousy walking in. A shot blocked by St. John. Follow in front, save Scheibe, and he covers up as they whack at the puck in the crease.
Couple of opportunities there for Grand Rapids again. Scheibe strong as he's been all day long, and he had to be because right on the doorstep, both Cousy and Roy banging away at that puck. They steal the puck, and you see right here, it comes across to Cousy in front. And look at him, he's trying to jam that puck in front, and Roy comes in behind him, also takes a poke at it, but Scheibe staying very strong on it, not allowing that puck to come loose.
4 minutes and 5 seconds remain in regulation, tied at two. Each team with a goal here in the third period. Both of Rapids' goals have been on the power play. Here's Roy in the corner, looking it around to the near side. Wilson fighting for it. He's spun around by Paul Cochran. Now in the corner, Wilson dumping it behind the cage, and there's nobody there for the Indians. Now Fairchild comes in to take it. His centering pass at the back of the net. Fairchild again, circling the cage. Throws it on. Scheibe covers up. The Rapids putting a little pressure here with 3:38 remaining.
Rapids not using the points too often. When they get control of the puck down deep, Kennedy's sort of halfway up the ice with their wings, and the points are open. They're standing out there. Retka and Knobs were both open for a shot there. They might have been able to get a shot on net and a rebound.
Oh, a quick shot pushed by Nielsen on net. Scheibe puts it away. Here's Nielsen's centering pass, and a diving Cochran broke it up. And finally, the puck comes to Trimborn. Off to Markstrom, and Kennedy starts out. Markstrom down the right side. And he's pushed off the play nicely by Tony Retka. Ryan Knobs with it for the Indians. Head on the right. Back comes Nielsen, cranking up a blast from center that's high and wide. Now behind the net, Fairchild and Hansen's wound around to Markstrom on the far side. Good feed in the middle off Trimborn's stick. Now Trimborn will come back right wing. Trimborn dropping. Here's Connick in front, and the pass is missed by Markstrom. Good feed by Connick. And it's Pouzy back. He sends it in behind the Kennedy cage with 2:45 to play in regulation, tied at two. And now an icing call against Kennedy. They'll bring it back into the Eagles' end at 2:42 remaining.
Each of these clubs now is playing with a lot more confidence than they started out the game out. They're carrying the puck better. They're getting more control of the puck in each defensive zone. They're able to get a couple of opportunities. It's been up to Scheibe and Houston to keep this tight at two because they're getting opportunities. They've got the great skill to get free. They got some good shooters out there. Still tight at two. As you go down, it looks like that next one's going to be it now.
Here's Wehrle, a shot on that hit traffic and deflects wide. Marinucci, Kuzi, and Roy, the line for Rapids, and that one, Beltier, was outside the line, brought it back in.
Rapids defensemen now are pulling out a little quicker than they did in the first two periods. Kennedy might be looking to dump some by him and get a break, but Rapids now with a 2-2 tie and getting late in the game, their defensemen are pulling out a little quicker and playing it more safe than they had earlier in this game.
Peterson, Berg, and Thompson, the line for Kennedy. And here's Kirby St. John sending it into the right of Chad Houston. Berg whips on it, coming back to Vierling. Blue line shot blocked by the diving Kuzi. Kept in, a shot by Peterson goes wide. In the near corner, Thompson, who has the tying goal. Dumps behind the cage, but Marinucci there to take control for Rapids. Pushing it ahead, kept in by Vierling. Now Beltier ahead, it's banked to center. Vierling sends it back into the Grand Rapids end with 2 minutes to play in regulation. Now it's Tom Wehrle coming up the Rapids in front of his home net. Got it out to center. Here's Adam Roy, and he lost the puck in his skates as he crossed the line offside at 1:47 remaining.
Wehrle back in defense there, and his partner Beltier have been very strong. They're solid. Taking the body real well. At times they've even varied their play. There when Kennedy takes away the wings from him, Wehrle just stops, makes that short outlet pass and relieves the pressure. Both defenses, very, very, very heady. Played a solid game here because you know you got two high-powered offenses and yet we're tied at two. Kennedy, 13 straight games, they've scored more than four goals.
Fairchild playing center now for Rapids, takes a hit. He's spun around by Kevin David. Fairchild is centering Wilson and Nielsen. Another different line combination here for Lynn Ellingson. 1:25 in regulation behind the Kennedy net. And it's played now by Greg Hansen. Spun around, Fairchild whips it in front. Scheibe's stick on it. Fairchild again to the side of the net, right in front. It's cleared out and past the blue line. Retka over to Knobs. He banks it ahead, and here will be Nielsen coming down the right side. Nielsen in front for Wilson, and the pass went through him. And John Rushen clears to Brockle at center. We're in the last minute of regulation. If the teams are tied at the end of regulation, a 3-minute rest period, 8 minutes sudden death. 50 seconds. And it's Wilson at center, back in his own end, a dangerous pass, and it's poked ahead. Looks like Rapids in dire need here of a line change. Now the puck flipped ahead, nobody there. Kennedy charging in here. Scott shooting, deflected to the far side, and Roy will play it for the Indians with 30 seconds. Ahead, he's knocked down, and it's cleared back to center. Here's Connick for the Eagles, flipping it wide of Houston. You see the time remaining in regulation. Now Markstrom walking in front. Puck is knocked away and cleared past the line by the Indians. No icing. And we are staring in the face of sudden death. Rob Vierling for the Eagles, trying to be careful. And we will have overtime. A 3-minute rest period and then an 8-minute sudden death period without resurfacing the ice.
I suppose, Ted, you could say this is not a surprise. Both right. of these clubs got a great deal of balance. They've got strong goaltending, real good defense, and firepower up front. But defense usually beats firepower, and it sure nullified it today. 2-2 after three, and you know that each of these clubs capable of winning the whole thing. One rated number one, one rated number three coming in. So it's not unexpected that they're tied at the end of the game.
It is tied at the end of regulation. Kennedy and Rapids heading to overtime.
Find out how far your money can go at TCF. Just open or add to any qualifying account, and you're eligible for low one-way airfares on Midway Airlines. Like $69 to Dallas-Fort Worth, $109 to Florida, and just $119 to Phoenix. Contact any TCF office or the connection for details and see how far your money can go.
Selection and savings. It's all here at Menards. Save on the Bissell Carpet Machine Plus. Its deep cleaning action and powerful suction pulls out dirt and liquid on the spot. On sale, just $119. Sylvania light bulbs are on sale, too. Stock up now on soft white, energy pincher, and three-way bulbs. Inside frost bulbs are just 14 cents per bulb after mail-in rebate. Find bright ideas for your home at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
As we get set for overtime, let's go down to the ice and Scott Reynolds.
Coach Peterson of Kennedy should be pretty happy, Ted, with the way his team has played here in the third period, because they're doing what he wanted, what he said after the second period. I want you to check harder and quit trying to just knock the puck off the Indian stick. They've been taking the body harder and getting support from the second man coming across. And Grand Rapids, a strong third period team, comes out even. This one's down to the wire. Obviously, that slow start by Grand Rapids has been negated now, and they've really turned it up. But it's a pretty even contest here. Now it'll come down to maybe who's got the best legs, Ted.
All right, Scott, thank you. Let's take a look at the third period goals. We were tied at one heading to the third, and Grand Rapids got the lead on a power play.
A power play goal. If you see Nielsen coming to the left of your screen, right after the save is made, the puck comes free. Watch 16 pop in the screen just before the puck went by the pipe. He was able to get a stick on and put it away. It was a power play goal, the second power play goal for Grand Rapids. Here's Kennedy's goal. Watch Thompson on his belly in front, getting his blade on the puck. See that? Right as the shot is coming, he's getting knocked down, and he gets his blade on. Number 18, Thompson, Paul Thompson. You look at the saves of the goaltender, Scheibe with 26, Houston with 24. So you know this game's been easy.
Houston only had to make three in the third period. And, you know, Louis, during this break, Houston was up skating around. Scheibe was sitting on his knees catching a breather in front of the Kennedy bench.
Well, the attendance today thus far is 17,596. Going into our first overtime of this tournament.
Q Kennedy did not play in overtime this year. Grand Rapids has played two and won them both over Duluth East and Waro. It'll be Connick and Marinucci. And we start sudden death overtime. The winner to play Anoka in the semifinals tomorrow. Up play back behind the Kennedy net. Marinucci playing catch with Kuzi. Wilson is in front. Can't get the puck to him. Vierling broke it up. Falls on it but can't freeze it. Here's Marinucci. In the near corner. Ridden off by Scott. Trying to get it back at the point. Can't do it. Now it is kept in there by Wuerling. Set to the far side. Vierling spun around by Kuzi. Up at the blue line. Kept in Beltier with a flip that goes wide. Now Marinucci right in front. Hit the side of the net or the goaltender. And it's back to center. Now Trimborn, as Scott was playing without a stick for Kennedy. Here's Markstrom down the far side. Markstrom shovels in front and Worley was there to calmly break it up. Connick though keeps it in. Trimborn has it knocked away. Trimborn spun around by Marinucci. Marinucci trying to freeze it and gets it along the boards. A break in the action. We'll be right back with the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
If you're going to buy a new truck, there's no question the best place to go.
See your Vikingland GMC truck dealer. How come they don't call them your Northstarland GMC truck dealers?
Two of the premier teams in the state. Grand Rapids number one in the final poll. Kennedy number three, and we're in overtime. Tied at two. Here's Paul Thompson, centering pass knocked down by Knobs. And on the far side, Jeff Nielsen can't clear. Kept in by Hansen at the point. In the slot, here's Thompson for Kennedy. Centering for Peterson, he can't get a shot off. Adam Roy knocked him down, and Adam Roy will get a penalty in overtime. And a power play for Kennedy. When we come back, there's a break of the action. We'll be right back with the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
Find out how far your money can go at TCF Bank and earn low one-way airfares on Midway Airlines. Contact TCF for details.
You're going to see Adam Roy pull down Peterson in front of the net right here, and he's going to go off for a penalty, a two-minute penalty in overtime, tied at two. Kennedy getting the first power play of the overtime.
What a tough thing in all hockey, Louie, overtime is for the officials, because most people expect they're going to swallow the whistles, and it's difficult to make any sort of a call.
Well, it is. You've got to be consistent. If you're calling them all game, you call them in overtime. If you're not calling them all game, don't call them in overtime. And if, you know, it's a goal-scoring opportunity, you definitely have to make a call whether you've been calling them or not. That wasn't a goal-scoring opportunity, but he's been calling hooking, so you got to expect he will.
Oh, a shot right off the draw by John Rushen, blocked by the defense, and then it's golfed up into the crowd by Retka. So Grand Rapids now having to kill a penalty. Kennedy 0-for-3 on the power play in this game. And Rapids has Marinucci and Jeff Nielsen out to do it against Connick, Rushen, and Markstrom for Kennedy up front.
Well, what this does, too, is give Kennedy a breathing spell, even if they don't score, because Grand Rapids was putting on a lot of pressure on them for the last period of the game and part of this overtime.
Here's Hansen to Scott, down deep to Connick. Connick into the corner, John Rushen. Rushen back up top. This will be Mark Scott, tipped on the way, and it's cleared by Rapids with 1:30 remaining in the Kennedy power play. And Scheibe comes out to play it in the corner, and the puck somehow got centered out in front. Gary Peterson's heart just skipped an extra beat. Here's Rushen in, centering pass deflected up into the crowd by Tom Worley.
Well, Scheibe came out to play that puck. He gave it over to Nielsen. Nielsen made a smart play. He knew the goalie's out of the net. He sent what you call a hoper pass into the center zone area of the offensive zone, hoping one of his players was there to shoot into the empty net. But his other wing was just up the side from him, so Kennedy was able to play it.
Connick won another faceoff. He's been strong on draws in this game, and look at that one, golfed all the way down right on net. Scheibe clears it, but Kuzi will keep it in. 1 minute remaining on the man advantage now for Kennedy. We're in sudden death overtime, tied at two. And Hansen starting the rush. slowly to center now. He has to shoot it in. He winds around to the far side. Connick in deep. He's bumped by Worley. Beltier trying to clear, cannot. Markstrom with it. Now Markstrom playing it back behind for Russian. Russian and Connick play catch. Nice move. Connick swept away. Nice play by Tom Worley. And the puck out to center. 25 seconds on the man advantage. And Scott backhands it in. Kennedy changing up all five. If Beltier can hurry, he'll clear, but he cannot. Kept in by Thompson. Shot blocked. And it comes to Wilson for Grand Rapids. Ahead, in comes Kruse, and it's an offside.
That was offside. The crowd's booing, but it was too soft a pass. Whenever you're going to move that puck and a man's open, pass it crisply. Put something on it. Otherwise, the receiver's just got to wait for it. In a case like that, while he's waiting, he's just gliding, and he glided far enough, he went offside. It would have just been a two-on-two, but still, Grand Rapids would have had control in the zone of Kennedy. With only 12 seconds left in the penalty, they might have been able to kill off the remaining time.
Down to 12 seconds on the Kennedy power play, and I imagine the legs are feeling heavy right now. The ice is probably a little slow.
Well, you know, Kennedy's been going more with two lines than Grand Rapids has, so, as I said,
Fairchild ridden down hard by Vierling, and the penalty is over. So Grand Rapids killing a penalty in overtime.
Just killing the clock helped Kennedy there.
And there's an offside against Grand Rapids. A break of the action. We'll be right back with the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
It's here. $5 million worth of cars, trucks, and RVs. Auto Show 90 revs up at the new downtown Minneapolis Convention Center. Make tracks.
Grand Rapids with a very important penalty kill. Now that it's over, 2-2 tie here in the first overtime, and Grand Rapids looked very, very strong in the third period and continuing their play here in the overtime.
4:29 remaining in the first sudden death overtime period. Now here comes a man in for Rapids, and a shot goes just wide off the stick of Jeff Nielsen. Played back by Redgett center, ahead to Nielsen, in with Fairchild. He pokes it down deep for Nielsen. Centering pass at the side of the cage, and it's held there by Scheibe.
Well, it's never wrong to shoot the puck on a two-on-one, because a shot on goal is never a bad play. However, in that case, he was on a wide angle, and Adam Roy really played it intelligently. He stepped back. He was out 25 feet all alone. If Nielsen would have slid that puck over to him in the slot area, Roy would have had a lot of net to shoot at. Scheibe would have needed a big save to keep this game still going. But Nielsen elected a shot. He missed the far side, and the puck came out of the zone.
Off the draw, breaking out with it. Chase Brockle for Kennedy, coming in with Kevin David. Brockle goes by Beltier, centers in front, it goes through. Comes back to St. John in front, it's blocked and steered away. And here comes Kuzi back. Kuzi with Wilson. To Wilson in front, he shoots, scores! Jeff Wilson wins it for Grand Rapids.
What a great play. What a great play by Kuzi. Kennedy had a shot, and they took it at the net. The goalie couldn't see it. Fortunately for Grand Rapids, it comes free. Kuzi and Wilson come down the ice. A two-on-one pitcher-perfect play by Kuzi to Wilson. Look at Kuzi. He's going to far side, pulls the defenseman to him, then makes the play to Wilson all alone. Wilson gets Scheibe moving across and puts it away. An outstanding play by Wilson and Kuzi, and Grand Rapids the winner in overtime, 3-2. They're a fine hockey club. They got stronger as the game went along. After they had a slow first period, they certainly came on to take over the play in this game, and they continued to kill it in a very important penalty in the overtime to afford them the opportunity to get this goal.
That's so true. They earned that, to be shorthanded, kill it, and come back to win it. On the goal by Jeff Wilson at 4:10 of overtime. These two teams, two of the premier in the state, put on a great show. Just a marvelous game.
They certainly did. It was an evenly played game for the most part. Kennedy had the first period. Rapids start taking over in the second, and certainly took over in the third. And they just seem to get stronger. They've got a little more depth, I think, up front. Kennedy with a strong goaltending and defense managed to keep it a 2-2 tie, but Grand Rapids a little more firepower, a little more balanced firepower up front, and wins it in overtime 3-2.
So Lynn Ellingson's team on to play Anoka tomorrow. And Louis, isn't it interesting? Kennedy was so exceptional this year in specialty situations. And this game, Grand Rapids beat him in that. Rapids had two power play goals and killed four of their own penalties.
That's
off.
Right. Kennedy had only given up four power play goals all year long. And the first two opportunities Grand Rapids gets, they get two. So you can see that Grand Rapids, with their specialty teams, did win this.
All right. Not a bad start to the state tournament for 1990. Let's go down to Mark and Ralph.
Ted and Lori, that isn't an advertisement for this game of high school hockey. We'll never seen one. That is just an amazing showcase that we just saw here in the last couple of hours.
It's also an advertisement. We see Tom Worley from Grand Rapids coming off with his armor on Brad Connick of Bloomington Kennedy. Great sportsmanship and just a great game.
So Grand Rapids making it to the semifinals, trying after 10 years after winning the state championship in 1980, trying again, and they're taking that first big step. And live from the St. Paul Civic Center, this is continuing coverage of the 1990 Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament.
I remember when we were in high school, how excited we were to come down to the cities.
And how we dreaded riding for 6 hours in the back seat of a car.
Things are a lot better today.
We just drive one of these people movers from GMC.
Talk about comfort. It even makes a 6 hour drive to Roseau a pleasant trip.
And a safe trip too. Now that we have families, that's real important.
Don't spend any more time cramped up in a car.
Stretch out in a people mover from GMC.
Check it out at your Vikingland GMC truck dealer.
Glenwood Inglewood, a refreshing idea since 1884.
Particularly picky people do everything for picture-perfect soybeans. You pick at lamb's quarters and pesky pigweed and get pretty punchy pulling velvet leaf. But now you can tank mix new Pinnacle herbicide. It's extra punch, pounds problem weeds to a pulp. New DuPont Pinnacle, the post picky people pick.
Good job. Helping my daughters with their homework is something I really do enjoy, but sometimes their mom or I might not be around to help them when they need a question answered. Sometimes I get stuck on a problem. Well, now there is a new service to help children and their parents. It is called Hotline for Homework. It's sponsored by WCCO-TV and Time to Share. Teachers from Minneapolis and St. Paul's Teachers Federations are available between 4 and 8:30, Monday through Thursday. Dial Hotline for Homework, expert help for you and your children.
Okay, we have a very short time, RJ. Let's go right now to Scott Reynolds with the heroes of today's game. Scotty.
The winning goal scored by Jeff Wilson of Grand Rapids, but as you might expect, he's giving the credit to a teammate, right, Jeff?
Yeah, a lot of it. Troy Cousy. We were coming down a two-on-one, and Kuz played him perfectly. He had got the defense, sucked right over to him, and laid it across, and it was me alone on one-on-one on goalie.
What was your feeling as you saw that puck coming off Kuz's stick at you?
I was thinking to myself, one-on-one of the goalie, you know. A lot of times you don't score with a one-on-one, but I got him kind of sliding across there, and I just put it in the lower side.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Nice shot. And Coach Ellingson of Grand Rapids is with us as well. You had to be concerned a little bit after that slow first period, but then again, you told me you're used to that.
Well, we came out, that's been our trademark all year, is we just kind of come out and kind of weather storms and then pick it up in the second period. Tonight was a kind of example of that. We got better every period. We got a little better every period.
What'd you tell your kids going into overtime, Lynn?
Nothing much. We had been there before a couple times. We just wanted to make sure that we didn't cough the puck up on either blue lines and move the puck if we had a chance.
Anoka's next. You beat him 5-4 Christmas tournament up in Grand Rapids. So they've played you tough before.
Yeah, we had a real good game with them up there. They were ahead with those 4-1 going in the third period, and we beat them 5-4 in our own building at Christmas.
Congratulations on making the semis.
Thank you very much.
Coach Lynn Ellingson of Grand Rapids, winners in overtime against Bloomington Kennedy. A lot of people said this would be the championship game. The number one team in the state against the number one team in the metro area. We don't need any more controversy with the two-tier controversy going on, but maybe they need to seed the teams in the state tournament, Ralph.
And no, one through eight,
so we don't have this great matchup in the first round.
No, I'll tell you what, every time you think about things like that, it never works out that way, though.
Okay.
I've seen too many of these things. They don't give you the trophy after the first day, but that's the way it works.
Don't tell Anoka that this was the championship game either.
Well, we already saw, and we're going to repeat it again, the TCF play of the game, and this is one that was heard all the way and seen all the way to Grand Rapids this afternoon. It was Jeff Wilson making the TCF play of the game in overtime, and one that I'm sure he'll be looking at his VCR over and over again.
Of course, he gave credit to Troy Cousy. We've all heard of Bob Cousy, the passer from the Boston Celtics years ago, but boy, this Cousy really put one on the stick right there.
And Jeff Wilson getting the goaltender out of position to knock in that overtime goal. 3-2 the winner, Grand Rapids. So they will face Anoka in tomorrow afternoon's first semifinal game. Of course, RJ, we have two excellent quarterfinal games coming up tonight. We've already had 2 one-goal games.
Yes, indeed, and that starts with Minnetonka taking on Burnsville, a couple of late conference teams in game one.
And then it'll be Roseau against White Bear Lake in that second game. Let's take a look at the championship bracket. Anoka defeating South St. Paul 2-1 earlier today, qualifying for that first semifinal game. And of course, as you just saw here, Grand Rapids over Kennedy 3-2. As you mentioned tonight, Minnetonka against Burnsville. And they're no strangers to each other, Ralph.
No, sir. As a matter of fact, I think the quote of the tournament has to go to John Erickson of Minnetonka. He said that when he checked into the hotel, the bellman said, "Mr. Eichelow, you look different without your hat on." It's been Edina so many years, but Minnetonka and Burnsville have been battling in the league conference for some time.
So take a breath and rejoin us about 2 hours from now, 7 o'clock, the time for our next game between Burnsville and Minnetonka. So for Ralph John Fritz, this is Mark Rosen, live from the St. Paul Civic Center. We'll see you in a couple hours. Good afternoon.
Hockey 90. The 1990 Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament has been brought to you by TCF Bank, where you can fly for as little as $69 on Midway Airlines. Your Viking Land GMC truck dealers. GMC, it's not just a truck anymore. Menards, the Midwest's complete home improvement headquarters. Rollerblade inline skates. Rollerblade, if not now, when? The Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament is an exclusive presentation of WCCO Television Sports.